In this video, we'll demonstrate how to use the tools available in Dataset Toolbox to review and evaluate SRH 2D solution data. Let's start by opening an existing SRH 2D project in SMS. This project contains two SRH 2D simulations with solution datasets for each simulation. Before using the Dataset Toolbox, I'll briefly review some basic concepts related to working with datasets. A dataset is a set of values associated with each node in the SRH 2D mesh. The values in the dataset can be scalar values or vector values. A scalar dataset contains a single value for each node, while a vector dataset contains two values per node. The two values represent the X and Y components on the vector dataset. A dataset can be steady state, which means a single time step, or transient, which means multiple time steps. Scalar datasets are typically visualized with contour plots and vector datasets with vector arrows. Note the SRH 2D solution datasets here in the Project Explorer. This icon indicates a scalar dataset. This icon indicates a vector dataset. This special Z icon identifies the scalar dataset for the elevations of the nodes in the mesh. Note that when I click on a dataset, I see that it becomes the active dataset with the dataset name and icon in bold. Right-clicking on a dataset and selecting Info reveals information about the dataset, such as number of time steps, minimums, maximums, and averages. Moving to the graphics window, I can interact with the nodes in the mesh. When selecting a node, dataset values for the node can be seen here. The Z field is the elevation. The S field is the active scalar dataset, which is depth. And the VX and VY fields are the X and Y components of the active vector dataset, which is velocity. Since the datasets are transient, the time steps are shown in this window. Note that as we cycle through the times, the contours, vectors, and values for the selected node update in the field at the top. Let's move now to the Dataset Toolbox and demonstrate how to use the tools there to evaluate the SRH 2D solution datasets. We will start by working with the Data Calculator, which is one of many tools in the Dataset Toolbox. The Data Calculator can be compared to a regular scientific calculator, but the arguments for mathematical operations are entire datasets instead of single values. Let's create a new dataset that compares the water surface elevation datasets of the two simulations in our project. This can be done by selecting the Compare Datasets function or by using the Data Calculator. With the Data Calculator, add the water surface elevation dataset of the first simulation to the expression, and then subtract the water surface elevation dataset of the second simulation. Next, assign a new name and click Compute. The result is a new scalar dataset where the values are the difference between the two water surface elevation datasets for each time step. Another operation that we may want to perform is to compute the maximum water surface elevation for each node across all time steps. This is done with the max function, and we will execute this function twice to compute the maximum water surface elevation for each simulation. In addition to computing maximums or minimums across a range of time steps for a single dataset, the max and min functions also can be used to compare two datasets. Using the newly created datasets as arguments, let's now use the max function to compute the maximum water surface elevation of the two simulations. The result is a scalar dataset with a single time step. The values represent the maximum water surface elevation for each node and across all time steps for both simulations. Note that the new datasets appear in the Project Explorer and can be contoured and visualized the same as any other dataset. Let's switch to the depth dataset and look at the contours. Note how the contours cover the entire mesh, even where the values are zero. Contrast this with the water surface elevation dataset. Note that the dry areas do not have contours drawn. This is because the water surface elevation dataset has an activity array associated with it to indicate active and inactive nodes for the dataset. It can be helpful to have the activity array of this dataset mapped to the depth dataset or any other dataset, and we can do this in the dataset toolbox. Now notice that the depth contours are rendered based on an activity array, making it easier to visualize the wet-dry boundary. Another approach that we could have used to do this is the filter tool. The filter tool creates a new dataset based on specified criteria. If we didn't have an activity array from another dataset to map from, we could filter the depth values such that any value less than or equal to zero is replaced with a null or inactive value. Other tools in the dataset toolbox include the Compare Datasets tool, which was mentioned earlier. This tool is used to compare dataset values on different geometries or meshes. The Merge Datasets tool combines the time steps of two datasets into a single dataset. This is useful if, say for example, you have a model run from 12 to 24 hours and would like to append it to a model run from 0 to 12 hours. This tool could be used to create a single dataset with time steps from 0 to 12 hours. The Sample Time Steps tool is used to create a new dataset from sampled times of an existing dataset. The Scalars to Vectors tool converts a pair of scalar datasets to a vector dataset. The dataset pair could either be VX and VY or magnitude and direction. The Vector to Scalars tool breaks a vector down into VX and VY, or magnitude and direction, scalar datasets. The remaining tools in the dataset toolbox are either not commonly used or used mainly for coastal applications. This concludes the Dataset Toolbox demonstration. More information about each of the tools in the Dataset Toolbox can be found on the SMS Wiki pages.